I'm Audrey Tan, and this is Our Better Nature, a series showing you how Singaporeans are innovating to improve Singapore's environment for the future. In this episode, we visit a vertical indoor farm at Admiralty to find out how it grows a ton of vegetables in a day. We also drop by a factory in Woodlands to see how alternative meats and seafood are made from plant-based powder. But just how does food made and grown locally help the environment? For one, it reduces the need for transportation by air, which has a large carbon footprint. There is also more control over what goes into what we eat. And finally, less reliance on the livestock sector for food, which is responsible for 14.5% of global greenhouse gas emissions.
I want to see the texture, because you know, fish fingers are about the texture.
Yeah, it's all about the texture and the taste.
I'm at Growthwell Foods, a three-year-old company founded on a vision to create plant-based nutrition for Asian palates.
Yeah.
Yeah, it really does look like real fish. Yeah.
This is one of the innovation that the company has created. And I think you can also see some of the products over here. Actually, a lot of people, when they think about plant-based food, they might still not be equally informed. And many times, if you ask people what is plant-based food, they'll tell you, oh, this is the char siu that I eat at hawker center made from gluten. But actually, we have noticed that alternative protein has really evolved over time with better technology. And you could see over here a range of core ingredients we use to create plant-based food options. You have soy protein isolate that we use to make our chicken nuggets. You have konjac powder, which is a very high fiber ingredient we use to make our seafood range.
Aside from fish sticks, the company also produces plant-based fish and chicken patties, popcorn chicken, and nuggets. And it all starts here at the factory at JTC Food Hub Senoko, with one of Singapore's first high-moisture extruders.
The reason why high-moisture extruder is so important, right, can come and take a look, is because we are able to then blend different protein powder, whether it's soy, chickpea, mung bean, and really through the unique twin screw extrusion process, create cleaner ingredients, cleaner raw materials with less additives to form the base of our meat and seafood alternative. So as the extruded product comes out into a belt, this is usually like the slab or the belt format. And then you can actually dice it into a mince. You can cut it into chunks. This allows us to have different variation to create texture in a meat and seafood alternative.
Currently, Growthwell's facility has the capacity to produce about 4 million kilograms of alternative meat and seafood per year. Singapore currently imports more than 90% of its food, but is building its agri-food industry's capability and capacity to sustainably produce 30% of its nutritional needs locally by 2030. To achieve this ambitious 30 by 30 goal, the Singapore Food Agency is leveraging technology and innovation as key enablers to transform the industry into one that is highly productive, climate resilient, and sustainable. Of course, Singapore is only so big, and land can't easily be given over to farming. So when it comes to producing more food here, you could say that things are looking up. Take Sustania, for instance. It opened its first farm in 2013 in an office building.
So our aim is to use technology to find ways to grow produce at the heart of the demand. And how we do this is via a controlled environment system where we are able to control all parts of the environment and all factors so that we can grow traditionally imported crops right here in Singapore. So for every pack of products produced that we are able to send to our consumers, they are 100% clean, such that you can eat straight from the pack without even washing. So that saves energy as well as water for on our consumer side as well.
In one day, the company produces a ton of kale, spinach, lettuce, and arugula, which is sold in supermarkets here. Its farms are no more than 60 minutes from the city centre, and Sustania prides itself on the consistency of its produce thanks to regulated light and water.
So if you look around, you can see in terms of the size of our lettuce heads here, they are all of consistent size. And this is very much enabled by the technology stack that we have put together. Firstly, we are able to provide consistent lighting hours to our crops, just the right amount of intensity for them. And we are also able to ensure that through our hydroponic system, we are able to provide consistent amounts of crop nutrition for the plants. And the result here is that we are able to see consistent output, and hence we are able to ensure we provide some sort of food resilience to the cities that we operate in.
Adjacent to the plant-based world of alternative foods, Singapore is also blazing a trail in the business of cultivated meat. In 2020, it was the first country to approve the sale of cultured chicken by California food tech firm Eat Just. By 2023, the company's Good Meat division is set to open Asia's largest cultivated chicken meat facility. It's not just startups that are looking to help our health and environment. At Nanyang Technological University, students from the Food Science and Technology program are finding new ways to provide us with sustainably derived options from plants and food byproducts. These include a plant-based ingredient to replace eggs and dairy in mayonnaise, and an oil from microalgae that could replace the use of palm oil.
This pink powder is actually the probiotic powder that you could take in your pill form in the mornings. Typically, we obtain this gum from acacia trees, but in this case, you know, we don't have acacia trees in Singapore, but we do have something, and that is durian seeds, one of Singapore's favorite fruit. So this is actually rich in a gum as well, and what we would do in the lab is to extract the gum from these durian seeds into something you see here, and then we mix this with the probiotics, and you get this little pink liquid here. And from here to here, basically we use the spray dryer that you just saw earlier to convert it into this encapsulated form.
Considering how much durians Singaporeans eat, I think that's a very good way to make use of all these unwanted seeds.
There's been a lot more traction in this field lately. I think also because of developments in the industry, it's becoming more cost effective. So that really is what drives consumer adoption. And I think right now we are really at this wave of the next food revolution, and we're about to see a lot of exciting new innovations everywhere.
To reach our 30 by 30 goal, we may need a collective shift in mindset to accept these future foods. Are you ready to make the move? Check out the Singapore Green Plan 2030 website to find out more.